All right, good afternoon, everybody. Welcome to the September 1st noon briefing from the St. Lucie County Emergency Operations Center. My name is Howard Tipton, and I serve as the St. Lucie County Administrator. With me this afternoon are St. Lucie Commission Chair Linda Bartz, Commissioner Franny Hutchinson, Sean Mitchell, Chris Sadowski. We have Public Safety Director Ron Parrish, Sheriff Ken Mascara, School Board Superintendent Wayne Gent, Fort Pierce Police Chief Diane Hobley-Burney, Port St. Lucie City Council Member Dr. John Carvelli, Port St. Lucie Police Chief John Bulldog, St. Lucie County Fire Chief Nate Sparrow, Fort Pierce Mayor Linda Hudson, Fort Pierce City Manager Nick Mims, and St. Lucie County Health Department Administrator Clint Sperber. So as we've watched the forecast this morning, both in the early morning and then at the 11 o'clock update, we see that we have a strong storm that is just off of our coast. So again, as we mentioned yesterday, everything that the storm does dictates what we do. And so we will have some additional announcements this morning. So let me run through first the storm track. So Dorian has grown to a strong Category 5 hurricane. That is the strongest category of hurricanes that we have. Sustained winds of 180 miles per hour, which is stronger than Hurricane Andrew and makes it the strongest hurricane ever measured through the Bahamas. The intensification as well as a slight move to the west will result in additional protective measures today. Currently, St. Lucie County is under a hurricane watch. That's as of 11 a.m. this morning, a flood warning as of 11 a.m., and a tropical storm force warning as of 5 a.m. this morning. It's recommended to take this storm seriously and watch for floods and increased coastal flooding. We'll talk about storm surge in a second. Please continue to pray for the northern Bahamas as they are currently experiencing what will likely be catastrophic damage. The forecast track has shifted to the west, that's towards St. Lucie County and the Treasure Coast. Dorian is located 216 miles east of Hutchinson Island and moving west at 7 miles per hour with tropical storm force winds, a field of 225 miles. Given this forecast uncertainty, the risk for damaging winds and flooding is steadily increasing as a result of this forecast change. The track will likely shift further over the coming days. They always do. Small changes to the forecast can mean big differences in realized impacts at any given location. What the National Weather Service shared this morning was that this is perilously close, that the winds are intensifying, and that it is going to basically stall just off of our coast. And it will be here for a long period of time. So again, remember that this is a marathon, not a sprint. And so there can be hurricane fatigue and storm fatigue. We're not into the storm itself yet. So, you know, got to pace yourself. But this is a big one. You need to continue to monitor, and we will be here throughout the event providing updates again this evening at 5, and then we'll be starting our updates at 8 o'clock tomorrow morning. Again, protective actions that you can take. Continue to make sure that you've got food and supplies. Make sure that you are, if you've put up your shutters, we've actually heard this, people were taking down their shutters based on the track change yesterday. If you've gone to the trouble of putting up your shutters, let's keep them up through this storm event, please. We don't know yet where it's going, and there's still time if you haven't put up your shutters to go ahead and do that, but we encourage you to take all protective measures at your home. Again, follow the local news reports, tune into our briefings at 8 a.m., noon, and 5 p.m. on Facebook and WQCS, which is 88.9 FM. Evacuations. One of the changes from yesterday's briefing, mandatory evacuations are now going to be in effect beginning today at 2 p.m. for the barrier islands, as well as those living in manufactured or mobile homes and in low-lying areas. The storm surge is predicted right now to be 6 feet. 6 feet of water is a devastating amount, and we do not want anybody to be in harm's way, so this is a great time to get to higher ground. So take advantage of this mandatory evacuation. The sheriff's going to talk a little bit about how that's going to work, but mandatory evacuation for the barrier islands, mobile homes, and low-lying areas. shelters. The other change is that the county, to the previous update, will be opening up two additional general population shelters. This means that the county, as of 2 o'clock today, will have Fort Pierce Central, Lakewood Park Elementary, Treasure Coast High School, and Westwood High School, which is the county's only pet-friendly shelter. Additionally, as announced yesterday, the special needs shelter at the Fenn Center in Fort Pierce will also open up at 2 p.m. today. This is a special needs shelter only, and to clarify prior news events, this is not a pet-friendly shelter. It is only for special needs. The county urges residents to utilize the shelters as a last resort. If you have the ability to stay with family and friends, please make those arrangements now. Make sure you let people know what your plans are. Continuing, all St. Lucie County government offices and facilities, including the St. Lucie County Public Schools, remain closed until further notice. Information lines. St. Lucie County's information lines here at the Emergency Operations Center are currently in operation. This is the 772-460-HELP or 4357. They'll be in operation until 8 p.m. tomorrow, or excuse me, 8 p.m. tonight, and then beginning tomorrow, they will be in a 24-hour setting. Tomorrow, we were going to transition from a level 2 activation, which is a partial activation, beginning 8 a.m. tomorrow morning. We will be at a level 1 activation, and we will stay in that status through the remainder of the storm event. With that, I am going to turn it over to the sheriff, who will have some additional comments. Again, please take this storm very seriously.
Mr. Tipton, thank you. Thanks for your leadership, too. As I mentioned yesterday, we can all agree this storm is very unpredictable. Now's the time to be extra vigilant, prepared, and have your plan in place. First thing you'll notice, there's an increase of governmental representatives behind us. That's because our concern has grown, and so should yours. In regard to the shelters, many times people ask me, are shelters safe? Are we going to be well protected? Is there food there? Yes to all those questions. The shelters will be manned by volunteers, Red Cross personnel, as well as a complement of usually 12 to 15 deputies on site. So these shelters are very, very safe. If you need to use a shelter, please do so. Again, I'm going to repeat my warning about those who want to take advantage of the situation on our residents. And I think on your screen right now will be a video from last night of someone attempting to burglarize a house that has been vacated in the storm. And this was sent to us by Ring. And we are watching for this type of activity. This kind of activity will definitely go to jail with no bond until first appearance. In regard to the evacuations, we are going to make a mandatory evacuation of North and South Hutchison Island, all manufactured home communities, and all low-lying areas. We are doing this not to put added stress in your life. We are doing this because we are concerned for your safety. You can replace your things, but you cannot replace your life or your loved ones. So please, please take this seriously. Effective tomorrow at 8 a.m., I'm going to repeat it again, effective tomorrow at 8 a.m., access to North and South Hutchison Island will be limited to residents and business owners only. Sheriff's deputies and Fort Pierce police officers will be manning the west side of the bridges. You will need identification to get back on the island as a resident or a business owner. And please realize we are in the customer service business. We are here to serve your needs. If in fact you are a resident or business owner, we want to make sure you get back to the island safely. That's our goal. And when this thing hits, we're there to make sure you are not victimized by people wanting to access the islands. So please realize tomorrow at 8 a.m. we're going to limit access. You must have two forms of documentation to get back on the island, proving that you are a homeowner, a resident, or a business owner. At some point in time, the winds will get high enough that we will actually close total access to the islands. We won't know at what time that will occur until we move closer to this weather event. Following the storm, it is very important to let us do our job. Let us get out, assess the damage, make sure that the bridges are safe for you to travel back home, and make sure there are no live wires or any deep water that can cause harm or even death to you. So again, be kind to each other. God bless you all, and we hope this thing wobbles a little bit east.
Thank you, Sheriff. As you mentioned, we have a strong team, not only behind me, but working in the Emergency Operations Center, working throughout the community. And that includes the state of Florida, who's been a great partner with us and up to this point and will be throughout this storm event. So again, take this event seriously. You still have time to prepare. Do not let your guard down. Continue to monitor all of the things that you need to do. If you are going to leave, make sure you let somebody know. We're going to have another update at 5 p.m. this afternoon. We are, following this briefing, going to do the briefing in Spanish and then in Creole as well. So if there is nothing further from the group behind me, again, I thank you all for being here. You have a great experienced team here in St. Lucie County, and together we get through this. So thank you.
Thanks for everything. Appreciate it. Hey, bud, good to see you.
Muy buenas tardes. Esta es la actualización del mediodía del Centro de Operaciones de Emergencia del Condado de St. Lucie. La trayectoria de la tormenta. Después de nuestra conversación con el Servicio Meteorológico Nacional esta mañana y mirando el aviso de las 11 de la mañana, Dorian ha crecido a un fuerte huracán de categoría 5 con velocidades de viento sostenidas de 180 millas por hora, que es más fuerte que lo que fue el huracán Andrew. La intensificación, así como un ligero movimiento hacia el oeste, dará lugar a que el condado de St. Lucie haga algunos anuncios adicionales para las medidas de protección de hoy. Hemos hablado antes con respecto a nuestras acciones y decisiones basadas en el pronóstico de la tormenta, y a medida que la trayectoria evoluciona y cambia, también cambian nuestros planes. Actualmente, St. Lucie County está bajo vigilancia de huracán. Desde las 11 de la mañana, advertencia de inundaciones y una advertencia de tormenta tropical. Se recomienda tomar esta tormenta muy en serio y estar atento a las inundaciones y el aumento de las inundaciones costeras. A medida que sigue cambiando, debemos reaccionar también. Por favor, continúen orando por las Bahamas del Norte, ya que actualmente están experimentando lo que probablemente sea daños catastróficos. Situación actual de la tormenta. La trayectoria se ha desplazado hacia el oeste, hacia St. Lucie County. Dorian está ubicada a 216 millas al este de Hutchinson Island y se mueve hacia el oeste a 7 millas por hora con fuerza de tormenta tropical que se extienden hasta 225 millas. Dado el pronóstico incierto, el riesgo de daños por vientos y las inundaciones aumentarán. Es probable que la trayectoria cambie más en los próximos días. Pequeños cambios en el pronóstico pueden significar grandes diferencias en los impactos realizados en cualquier ubicación dada. Estaremos aquí durante todo el evento monitoreando la tormenta en un esfuerzo por mantener a todos seguros. Acciones de protección. Antes de la llegada del huracán, asegúrese de mantener suficiente comida, medicamentos y agua durante de 3 a 5 días, ya que esta tormenta se mueve extremadamente lenta. Tenga un montón de baterías y mantenga sus teléfonos y tabletas cargados en caso de un corte de luz. Confiamos en que se hayan puesto sus persianas en las ventanas y asegurados sus patios. Si va a evacuar, asegúrese de informar a sus familiares y vecinos de su plan. Los residentes con necesidades especiales y aquellos residentes con mascotas necesitan preinscribirse para recibir refugios si planea hospedarse en un refugio local, llamando inmediatamente al 772-464-7433 para hacer esos arreglos. Asegúrese de tener todo lo necesario: agua, comida, medicamentos. Manténgase informado con los reportes de las noticias locales. Tendremos informes todos los días al mediodía y a las 5 de la tarde por Facebook y WQCS 88.9 FM. Líneas de información: el Centro de Operación de Emergencia del Condado St. Lucie está actualmente en un nivel 2 o una activación parcial. El número de información del Condado St. Lucie es el 772-460-4357 y está disponible de 8 de la mañana a 8 de la tarde. Y los ciudadanos con preguntas deben llamar a este número y no al 911. Refugios. Hoy a las 2 de la tarde, el Condado St. Lucie, con las Escuelas Públicas de St. Lucie y la Cruz Roja, está movilizando los refugios para la tormenta. Actualmente estamos abriendo nuestros refugios para necesidades especiales en el centro Harvest Elfen y dos refugios de población general en las escuelas Fort Pierce Westwood Prep y Fort Pierce Centro. Todos los refugios abrirán a las 2 de la tarde hoy, domingo 1 de septiembre. El condado insta a los residentes a utilizar los refugios como último recurso. Si usted tiene la capacidad de quedarse con familiares y amigos, por favor hágalo ahora. Las oficinas cerradas. Todas las oficinas, incluyendo las oficinas del secretario de la corte, las cortes, las oficinas de los impuestos, las oficinas del supervisor de elecciones y todas las escuelas del condado estarán cerradas hasta próximo aviso. La reunión de la Junta del Condado del martes 3 de septiembre y la audiencia de la Junta de Cumplimiento de Código del miércoles 4 de septiembre han sido canceladas y serán reprogramadas para una fecha posterior. El número de información general es el 772-460-4357 y está disponible todos los días de 8 de la mañana a 8 de la tarde. El condado está en Facebook y en Twitter también en @StLucieGOV y en la página web del condado www.stlucieco.gov. Y una vez más, el alguacil del condado informa que los que quieran aprovecharse de esta situación para cometer cualquier tipo de crimen durante la tormenta serán arrestados inmediatamente. Cualquier persona arrestada durante este estado de emergencia no tendrá fianza hasta que se presente delante de un juez. Y si observa precios altos de gasolina, repórtelo llamando al 911 o a la oficina del fiscal general de la Florida al 866-966-7226. Muchas gracias.
Bon après-midi, peuple haïtien. Ça, c'est une nouvelle midi qui sortit dans le bureau Emergency St. Lucie County. Howard Timpton, avec plusieurs administrateurs St. Lucie County, te délivre message ça en anglais. Conversation nous fait avec Service national des temps avec nouvelle noue à 11h le matin. Fait nous connaître mauvais temps Dorian mouté yon catégorie 5 avant mouté 180 000 et des temps. Ça fait les pires dangers et plus danger que mauvais temps Andrew. St. Lucie County a fait plus honneur jodi a pour peuple ka protéger. Nous déjà parlé des actions avec décision a fait dépend des changements à route temps fait. Kounya St. Lucie County a veillé temps mauvais la pluie avec inondation de l'eau. Nous encourager moun prend ça très sérieux. Faut que nous changer à tout changement temps ça fait. Nous voulons continuer Kembe Bahamas nan pense nous avec prier nous parce que tant ça ka fait un pile dommage. Trace tant ça mouté sous bord droite Saint Lucie County. Mauvais tant ça avec mauvais vent qui a fait un pile dommage. Trace tant ça qui a fait plus, qui a passé plus loin ou bien qui a passé plus près nous. Dans le jour qui a venu, tant ça qui a changé direction. N'importe changement qui a fait un pile effet. Action nous décide de faire, à dépend de qui route tant ça fait. Changer, sécurité, c'est premier objectif nous. Deuxième objectif nous, c'est affaire nous. Ou ka replacer besoin, mais ou pas ka replacer tête ou bien famille. N'a continuer veiller tant pour nous ka assurer tout monde gain sécurité. Kounya m'a expliquer nous ki jan nous ka faire préparation. Assurer ou gain manger, de l'eau avec médicaments pour 5 jours. Faut qu'ou gain batterie avec chargeur cellulaire pour toute technologie communication. Nous souhaitons ou gain couvrir caillou porte avec tout bocaillou. Suspend retirer branche bo précaillou parce que moun cap pas ramasser. Si ou décidez évacuer di famille avec zami ki bo fè. Moun ki gen besoin spécial ou bien si ou gen bête, faut qu'ou préregistrer pour ka joindre sécurité. Si ou voulez joindre sécurité locale, relais 772 464-74-33 immédiatement. Veillez nouvelles locales à 8h du matin à 5h le soir sur Facebook avec radio 88.9 FM. À 2h PM jodia, pep ki rete bo la main avec nan kay mobile ou soal fabriqué obligé évacuer. Saint Lucie County ouvert des auditionnels sécurité publique. Jodi à 2h après-midi, n'a pouvi sécurité publique pour moun ki gen besoin spécial nan Harvard L Center. Sécurité publique pour pep général ap nan toile l'école. Fort Pierce Central High School, Fort Pierce Westwood and Lakewood Park Elementary. Nous encourageons pep la utiliser sécurité publique pour dernière option. Si vous arrêtez avec zami ou soit famille, s'il vous plaît, faites enragement ça kounya. Bureau opération emergency nan Saint Lucie County rive nan opération nouveau D. Ça c'est ça veut dire activation partielle. Demain à 8h du matin, n'a mouté yon opération nouveau 1. Ça veut dire ça c'est une totale activation. Nous encourageons pep Saint Lucie County relais ligne 772 460 43 57 pour plus d'informations. Ligne ça a ouvri jusqu'à 8h du soir. La pourrait ouvrir avec 8h du matin ou 8h du soir. S'il vous plaît, si vous pas gain emergency, parlez 911. Relais 772 460 43 77. Tout bureau gouvernement Saint Lucie County a fermé. Et puis après t'es fermé jusqu'à ce que nous ba nouvelle y aurait ouvert encore. Toute réunion qui t'a faite Saint Lucie County Board of County Commissioners mardi septembre 3 à mercredi septembre 4 a fermé jusqu'à ce que nous dit nous y après nous y après ouvert. Si vous besoin information jodi a relais 772 460 43 57 8h du matin pour 8h du soir. Si vous pas gain emergency, s'il vous plaît, parlez 911. County a sur Facebook, Twitter, à Saint Lucie Gov, ou ka jwenn information sur net la nan www.saintlucieco.gov/hurricane. Merci beaucoup.